morning, everyone. Michael Gurley here with my daily blog post. I speak from my blog at michaelgurley.org. I've titled this, The Importance of Words. Sticks and stones can maim and bruise, but it's the power of words that can do more damage than we realize. Consider the importance of words you speak and hear. They can soothe and inflame, challenge and put down, calm and incite a riot, draw someone close and push them far away. Nathaniel Hawthorne says, words, so innocent and powerless as they are, as standing in a dictionary, how potent for good and evil they become in the hands of one who knows how to combine them. Isn't that interesting? Side by side in a dictionary. Potent, good, or evil in the hands of one who knows how to combine them. Words influence and challenges. Knowing how to put them together succinctly is a powerful tool in the hands of any person. Here's my thought today. Words can build up and tear down, inspire or bring crushing defeat. Words last a long time, even when the moment they are used passes us by. I can still hear words of my grandparents rattling around in my brain from over 60 years ago. Want some cream? Referred to ice cream as asked by my grandma. Grab those two wires and hold them together, was for my granddad who wanted me to hold those live and sparking wires of the heater blower under the dashboard of his 1957 Chevrolet Apache truck. It was the only way to keep the defroster working. Ain't no way, I said. I'm sure that was my response. According to scripture, it was the spoken word that framed everything we know. 10 times the Bible records the phrase from the author, and God said, at his spoken word, things happen. Not just acts of miracles, but acts of creation. If you think about this from those thousands of year-old phrases, we see that our words create an environment around us. Peace, hostility, truth, lies, love, hurt, anger, and joy. I had a manager that loved to tell little boy dirty stories in meetings. The ladies would look aghast, hide behind their hands, and then giggle as if hearing it for the first time. The guys would chuckle and nod their heads to show they were on his side. I chafed. It was not the time and place for an IT professional to show his little boy's side. Inappropriate, unprofessional, often vulgar. In private, that little boy's side became a grown-up with a vocabulary I never heard from other adults I worked with. I was never on his good side. Rachel Wolchin says, be mindful when it comes to your words. A string of some that don't mean much to you may stick with someone else for a lifetime. See, 30 plus years later, I remember him only by his language. Not by any good he may have accomplished in the organization. The attitude and purpose of our words are as important as the words we choose to use. The Apostle Paul referenced words and their usage often, many times speaking about them to congregations, cities, and countries. His words were used in person for years and finally in writing for centuries. I wonder if he knew how far-reaching his words would spread. If you ever watch actor Dean Jones in a stage production of St. John in Exile, you could envision the scriptorium where Paul and the other writers of the New Testament had their words translated and spread abroad. Paul said in 1 Corinthians 14:19, yet in the church, I would rather speak 5 words with my own understanding that I may teach others also than 10,000 words in a tongue. He considered words important and based on his own understanding so that he could teach others. He considered this more important than speaking or praying in tongues that others will not comprehend. His background was impeccable. Philippians 3, 5, and 6 describes it. He was taught by none other than Jesus Christ long after the resurrection. Galatians 1, 11, and 12. In other locations, he speaks about unspeakable words, few words, vain words, enticing words, flattering words. But it was the wording to Timothy, his protege, that takes on a deeper concentration of the use of words, phrasing that grabs my attention this morning. In 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 6, Paul says to Timothy, "If you instruct the brethren in these things, you will be a good minister of Jesus Christ, nourished in the words of faith and of the good doctrine which you have carefully followed." Notice the word instruct. Its origin alludes to the fact of laying down the information, and I take it to construe that you're building the foundation layer by layer. Doesn't this make you realize how important it is to use words to build up? He instructed what he devoted himself to and was nourished by those instructions laid down in his own life and could thus lay it down for others. We live in a world full of words. I walked down the aisles of a popular bookstore chain and I was struck by the millions, no, billions plus words that resided on the bookshelves just waiting for someone to peruse and maybe take home and dive in. Some writings are there to instruct, others are there to bring doubt, confusion, and anger, while others were only there to entertain. All my life I have gone to libraries to search for the written words that would explain the world to me, open up territories, challenge me to keep adding to my knowledge. It's even easier today to do this with software, but there is nothing like the experience of walking down the aisles of books that are the personal writings of millions of writers. Words are important. Think about it. Every language group in the world has its own share of words that are common to them and foreign to others. Slang, phrases, even meanings of words will take on a different life in a different culture, even country, and often change with the times. Some time back, I read an article titled 10 Quotes That Changed the Way We Look at the World by Nick Robbins early at the Huffington Post. It came to me via some social media or news outlet. I was intrigued enough to read and reflect. While I can agree with some of the words and phrases used that reflected change to those of their time, I think that there are specific words that changed me in the way I look at the world around me and hopefully brought change into the future. I know you have your own list, but here are a few that are life-changing to me. You can do it. And I hear the voice of parents and grandparents and siblings when I think of this phrase. Whether it was to challenge me to jump off that high cliff into Menard Creek when swimming, or helping me to find the courage to balance that bike on two wheels, or even later on a one wheel as we popped wheelies up and down the street. Jesus. You may think this strange, but I hear my grandmother speak his name often in my mind as a result of how she called upon him often. It's a habit I want to utilize, but it really only comes from knowing who he is, talking to him in prayer, and then knowing the power of the name. You accomplish much by depending on him so much. All you need to do is to speak his name. I am so proud of you. Graduating, completing a job, participating in a group effort, regardless of the situation, to know that someone is proud of me for the job well done, so I learn to say it to others. I love you. This stands alone, and we all know the power of love. Want to go with me? As a young person looking up to older ones around me, these were words I often yearned for. A friend, Buddy Creel, taking me for a spin in his 1955 MG, co-owned of course, or even asking me to take my first road trip to relocate the family to Wyoming when I turned 16. They needed a driver, yes! Or even asking me to eat out after church, spend the night, or sing in the choir. You are so blank, and then you fill in the blank for the moment. To one who never remembered me telling her she was beautiful, or to one I never said how much I appreciated them enough, or to another who I did not brag enough on, of their accomplishments. These are words we fail to speak often enough with feeling. Will you marry me? Choosing a life partner is very important, and I've only used this phrase one time and hope never to have to use it again. Even at the age of 18, I knew who I wanted and was willing to plant the remainder of my life with this woman of choice, even when others told me to wait a few years. Well, we're nearing a major milestone of 45 years, so there. We're headed for milestones. My parents just celebrated their 65th. This is a great goal to have. We are just about there. And you may not remember this song, but this phrase brings a song to my mind that just says, I'm longing for home. So I seldom get written responses to my blog, but I wonder if you would not take a moment and share some words that made a huge impact on you and the way you see the world around you. These words are important.